What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about top 5 SCCM 1910 features, so let's get started. All right, so these are my top 5 SCCM 1910 features that I've liked so far. I mean, there's a bunch of other features that 1910 has, but these are the ones that I've been using the most, or I've seen the most, because I'm always around SCCM constantly, so... Number 5, and again, this is no particular order. Number 5 is searching within the task sequences. This is awesome, especially if you have like a long crap load list of task sequences because you're customizing it for your 9-to-5 job and you want to search something because you need to update it or modify it rather than figuring out what variable you modified or you put it into. You could just go inside here and search it. It's pretty cool that Microsoft provided a drop-down menu to kind of narrow down the scopes. If you leave everything the default, it kind of basically goes everywhere. So on this example, I typed in underscore SMS because I created a variable within the options tab. So I was looking for it, and then it highlights everything where it sees underscore SMS, and then I'm able to go into it and just modify it with no problem. Number 4 on my list is a copy and paste within the task sequence. Now, this is awesome, especially within the options tab. If you create a lot of if and then statements when it comes down to the drivers, like for Dell or Lenovo, depending on what type of machines you're pushing out your image, and you create this huge condition statement, you don't want to retype it again. You select what task variable you want. And then when you select it, you have an option to copy it. When you copy it, you automatically get the paste. Now, the paste has a little arrow. If you click on it, it gives you options to paste it where you want it. You could do paste before, paste after, or paste under. Number 3 in my list is high performance. Okay, for high performance, it looks like when you have your task sequence enabled with high performance, it looks like it speeds up the time of pushing out your OS image to your machines, from my understanding. But to enable it, if you right click any of your task sequences and go to properties, and within properties you go inside the performance tab, and then you have this option which is turned off by default. You give it a check, run as high performance power plan, and then there you go. Number 2 on my list is this is awesome right here. I really like this option a lot because I've seen it on the past that when you're trying to import an operating system into your SCCM and that WIM file has a crap load of indexes, it takes all those index and push it down to your machine. We don't want that. On this option here, when you get to the point of browsing the data source of the operating system image, you have a new option that says extract the specific image index from the specific WIM file. So when you check that off, you get a nice little drop-down menu. When you click on that drop-down menu, you are able to pick that index to be imported within your SCCM. Number 1 on my list is a new variable that was introduced to pause in-place upgrades within Windows 10, especially if you are pushing out these upgrades within a high-performance workstation. Now, within your task sequence, you are able to go to Add General and then click on Set a Task Sequence Variable. This right here should be applied between apply operating system and then apply Windows settings, right? So this new variable should be in between those two. Then the task sequence variable would be set up complete pause with a capital S, capital C, and a capital P. Now the value for this variable should be in seconds. For my example, I gave it 60 seconds, which is a minute pause, and then it would continue doing the rest of the task sequence. Now, this is a bonus within my list, which is actually top 5 plus, but I really like it a lot. If you go inside your task sequence and you go inside apply Windows settings, it looks like within SCCM 19, they kind of improve the language features. So you're able to do the UI language far back, which is pretty cool. So you have more options to customize your image during task sequence process, which is pretty cool. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed my top 5 plus features of 1910, SCCM 1910. I mean, there's a lot of other features that I have not gone through, but these are my top 5 that I've kind of seen or touched because I'm always inside the task sequence. If there's a feature that you enjoy within your SCCM 19, leave it at the bottom at the comment section. Let me know what it is. I would definitely like to check it out. Don't forget about hitting that like button. Also, subscribe. And what else? Don't forget about sharing that video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.